We perform numerical simulations of bolted connections to study various aspects about them, such as the performance of a bolted connection under service loads, or selection of bolts that are suitable for a design, and even failure of the fasteners due to fatigue or thread stripping under external loads. In this lesson, we will learn about the choices or decisions that are to be made even before we start setting up the simulation. We'll try to emphasize on the importance of understanding the design criteria of a bolted connection and what is a simulation objective based on the failure mechanisms the design is prone to. Once we establish our modeling objectives, we can prepare the numerical model appropriately. The first aspect to consider is the type of analysis. Depending on the modeling objective, we can decide whether it is a static or a dynamic analysis. This includes deciding whether we perform a linear or a non-linear analysis. This way, we can establish the scope of details that can be included in the analysis. Next, we need to decide how to represent the bolts. The way in which we model the bolted connections can affect both the results we can extract from it as well as its computational efficiency. There are three questions that we need to ask ourselves before we start setting up the model. Is the bolted connection a point of interest or failure in the design? Is the bolted connection important in the load pattern? Or in other words, is it a load-bearing component in the assembly? And finally, is the loss of bolt preload a concern? For instance, in case of gasket, the loss of preload can reduce the sealing pressure of the gasket and result in leakages. We can ignore the bolted connections if the answer is no for any of these questions. In such cases, we can replace the bolted connections with contacts or other types of connections to improve the computational efficiency of the simulation. But if the answer is yes to at least one of them, then we must include bolts in the model. It's important to understand why the bolts are being evaluated in the model. The reliability and safety of bolted joints is of prime importance. The failure of even a single bolt is a safety hazard for the whole assembly. Hence, while evaluating the bolts in a given design, we must consider some important aspects. One such aspect is the load history. We need to understand the nature of the load acting on the assembly, such as is it monotonic loading or is it cyclic loading. This information is crucial to identifying the failure mechanisms in the bolts. For instance, bolts can undergo fatigue failure under cyclic loading, and it can occur suddenly without any visible changes, causing alarming consequences. On the other hand, monotonic loading may result in other failure mechanisms, such as bolt failure in tension, or thread stripping, or even loss of preload. For example, in case of gaskets and O-rings, the flexible part is pressed between the assembly parts under the pressure of the bolt head. Over the time, the gasket can creep, resulting in loss of clamp force, and this can cause leakage. All these aspects can affect both the accuracy and the efficiency of the model, and we need to find a proper balance between the two. While this is applicable to any simulation exercise, the bolted connections need special care because they usually appear in large numbers in most assemblies. Also, most bolted connections involve usage of contacts, which adds to the computational time. Due to large number of bolted connections, this additional time may be significant, especially when there are non-linear contacts. To balance our modeling needs and efficiency of the numerical model, we need to ask ourselves a few additional questions, such as, how should the bolt be modeled? Do we need to include full details such as the threads, or simplify the model and get rid of the threads? Also, can we go a step further and model the bolt as a line body with cross-section of the grip length of the bolt? We'll save the discussion on how to model the bolts in more detail in a later section of this course. But in this lesson, we'll focus on the threads. How important are the threads in our analysis? Do we need to include them in the model? We need to consider the threads when they are the point of interest. For example, let's look at the screw jack. The loading capacity of the screw jack is dependent on the strength of its threads and mode of failure for such a design. And thread stripping is the primary mode of failure for such a design. So in this case, we need to perform detailed thread modeling. However, in case of bolted connections, this approach is computationally very expensive. If you're interested in preloaded tension and shear bolted joints, we can ignore the threads. In such case, the focus is on the diameter of the bolt rather than its threads. So we can simplify the bolt geometry, which makes the analysis computationally efficient. Another important question is, how are the bolts connected to the rest of the assembly? Let's start with the interaction between the bolt head and the rest of the assembly. When the bolt is tightly fastened and there is no relative motion between the mating parts, we need not model the separation or sliding of the bolt from the rest of the assembly. In such cases, we can use a linear contact, such as bonded or no separation, between the bolt and the other parts. However, in some cases, we may have separation or sliding between the bolt and the assembly. A good example is the shear joints, where the sliding of the parts between the bolt head and the nut is possible. In such cases, we must use a nonlinear contact, such as frictional contact, which is slightly more expensive. Replacing such a contact with a linear form would be oversimplification, as the contact will be able to support any amount of lateral force in a shear joint, irrespective of the preload. That will adversely impact the accuracy of the results. On the other hand, we also need to define correct contact type between the bolt threads and the nut. When the bolts are tightened, there is no relative slippage between the bolt and the nut, in which case we can consider using a linear contact such as bonded contact. In fact, we can also ignore modeling the actual threads. But if the threads are of main interest, as discussed earlier, then we need to use a frictional contact between the threads to capture the slippage, which is again an expensive affair. For most practical purposes, the threads are simplified and replaced with a bonded contact between the nut and the bolt. With this, we can conclude the discussion on level of modeling detail in threaded fasteners.